was terrific because, first of all, the only play I'd written before Ghost Brothers of Darkland County was a play for my Boy Scout troop when I was 12, and my relatives just absolutely adored it. But, you know, I like the theater. I like the idea, the challenge of putting something on stage that's simple enough so that it can be seen without doing all the movie magic. And I was really sort of taken by the idea of doing something that was fairly simple, that could be put on almost anywhere. Like, John Mellencamp came to me and said, we can really do something here if you want to get behind it. And he told me the story, and I loved it. And, you know, we both thought maybe this thing will end up on Broadway, or maybe it won't. But Broadway has gotten so big now, and it's become almost like, I don't know, Disneyland for old people. You know, things like The Lion King and Spider-Man and Aida, they're more like e-ticket rides at an amusement park than they are like Tennessee Williams or Eugene O'Neill or that sort of thing. And I love the idea of collaborating with John. I knew him through his music, and I liked that. But the more I worked with him, the more I came to appreciate how talented he was and how it was really sort of energizing to kick these ideas back and forth and to mold the story, the words, around his music. And he did the same thing with the music and tried to mold it around the words, and seeing those two things come together was really interesting. And I like John. We both come from small town environments, and we're kind of just basically regular guys. He's been fun to work with, and hopefully, I know for one thing that the album, the cast album, will be out next year. It's got Elvis Costello and Sheryl Crow and Nico Case, who's terrific, and a bunch of other people, Dave and Phil Alvin, the Blaster Brothers, who haven't worked together for a long time because they're kind of like those brothers who are in Oasis. They don't like each other very much. But they related to the story about brothers who didn't like each other very much. So we just had a terrific time, and we put it on in Atlanta at the Alliance Theater and sold out the whole run of the show and got some pretty good notices, and we're moving on from there. What will eventually happen, I don't know, but I do know that this album will be out in March. The music was like steroids injected into the thing. The music is so emotional and so perfect for what I wrote. It's not the kind of thing that you see on Broadway that would be like the Phantom of the Opera or Les Mis or something like that. It's not operatic. It doesn't have a Broadway feel. It has a real roots Americana feel to it, and that's the kind of story that it is. We sort of both aimed at the kind of thing that Tennessee Williams was doing in A Streetcar Named Desire, that kind of feel, and, you know, you don't try to come up to that level. You just say, here's the benchmark, and try to go from there.